I'm Jeff Bradshaw with Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com. This is a 1982 Chevrolet 3/4 ton with a 6.2 diesel. I know.
Would you believe that hood insulation was completely intact when I parked it here about 6 months ago? Yes, indeed it was. Okay, here's the story. I got this gifted to me, and I called the people what used to have it because the person what gifted it to me got it in the non-running condition. So the people they got it from in the non-running condition said, well, we pulled it up in front of the office and it quit and then it wouldn't start. Well, there's a myriad of things that can happen when you say something like that, but here's what I found. I put a battery in it, turned the key, and I got nothing. So I jumped across this, used the jumper switch and jumped across the solenoid terminals, and I got nothing. So I took the starter off and I pulled the solenoid off, and I got this. That, ladies and gentlemen, is trashed. That post is supposed to have a screw in it, which goes right here. Well, that screw was broken off and melted. Of course, I don't know if it melted or broke off first. But given the fact that the one hold down bolt was stripped and the other one was super tight, I'm going to guess that this bolt was loose and caused a high heat situation because of the poor contact, which also translated into the poor contact on this washer. Because I've never seen one cook like this before. Seen plenty of arcing, but never seen one cooked before. So that's one of those things where somebody's cranking and it's going rrr, 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 and they just hold the key on and they keep going rrr, 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 rrr. And you're standing over in the side of the parking lot going, it's not going to start! So when I yank and crank my charger up to the 235 amp starting zone, and you hit this, not only do you get a blinding flash of light, oh, is she tired. You should feel this thing vibrate. So now with the new starter in it, it has no fuel. And we start looking at clues like, well, you know, that's a pretty recent fuel filter, which could mean that somebody was just doing maintenance or they were attempting a repair. But when we come in the truck and we turn on the key, look at the fuel gauge. It goes buried past full. So it does have dual tanks. And when you switch tanks, oh, it worked that time. Did you hear it? Ooh, it didn't do that yesterday. Oh, that gives me hope. I'll probably end up rebuilding it anyway. So, that is an open circuit. And regardless of which tank you choose, oh, wow, it didn't do that yesterday. This could take a while. I'm going to come back when it stops moving. Well, that gives me hope. So yesterday, both of these were buried on the full side, which means they both had open circuits, but now the right one is showing that it's almost full. I think I'll go grab my camera probe and try again. To see what we can see. I don't know if that's the bottom of the tank or what. No, that's not the bottom of the tank. That looks like that's the metal neck that comes up off the tank. So that's the last rubber hose. I guess it's easy enough to pull the fill hose apart. This is in my way. In fact, I can just as easily probe this as I can anything else. Where did that go? It's clear down inside the tank. I guess I can't just as easily do that. Let's try this again, shall we? Well, if I come into contact with some sort of fluid, well, no. I suppose I could just stick something in there. Dipstick. See how wet it gets? Let's pull it out and see if there's any wetness on here. No, there's no wetness on here. I don't think diesel fuel is going to hurt this any. That should be pointing at tank bottom. Okay, there's fluid. So we do have diesel fuel in this tank. Yep, got about a quarter inch showing on the end of the camera. Look clean in there on the bottom of the tank too. All right, we like that. Now, is it drawing off the right tank? Because we have a fuel tank switching valve. Time to recharge. Well, the fuel line was wet, so that was a good thing. Are we able to pump fuel from the fuel tank? Do we have power? Yes. Yellow is hot, blue is not. Let's see if I can deluge myself. Promising. Certainly should have had some by now. I wouldn't think that's the return line. Okay, so we're blowing air into the fuel, which means that the end of that line is below the fuel level. Maybe I need 5/16 hose instead of 3/8. Well, that's a quarter inch hose. What will I do now? Put this back on. Where's that clamp? That's on there plenty tight to not draw air. But this doesn't really seem so. That's not very tight. Let's try this again, shall we? Yellow is hot, blue is not. Point it away from you. After. Well, there's this dandy little bleeder mix thing right here. I'm supposed to see it come out that tube. Picked up the fuel. The fuel switching valve is on the right hand side. We ain't getting nothing. Notably not a thing. Well, I wonder if cranking it would help any. Well, since the hose clamp was loose on the outside of the pump, I decided to just pump fuel all over the top of the tank. Let's try it again. Oh, look at that! Air bubbles. Oh, I gotta go get something to stick under that. I really didn't think I was going to get this far today. Oh yeah, I have to do that, don't I? Nice, clean, clear fuel. So, we know the fuel switching valve is working. Well, we know that the fuel switching valve is on the right-hand tank. We also know we have to push through the mechanical fuel pump in order to get up to the filter. So what I would like to do then is disconnect the fuel pump, open the bleeder, relieve the pressure,
Oh, some more air. Wonder where that came from. Let's do that again.
Pressurize it. Turn the pump off.
Open the bleeder. Why, it did it again.
Are you able to see that? I don't think I look. I didn't give you the vision. Turn the pump on.
Open the bleeder. Air. Okay.
We don't care about glow plugs right now. We just want to see if the mechanical fuel pump is pumping.
The mechanical fuel pump is pumping.
Close the bleeder.
I'm going to go ahead and hook up the electric fuel pump anyway. Reconnect the glow plug relay. I only have one battery. Engage glow plug relay. Recycle glow plug relay. Keep recycling glow plug relay. I'm getting low on battery. That's not enough battery for me. I'm gonna charge the battery and come back to this tomorrow. But for you, it's in 3, 2, 1.
Okay, so picking up months later on this project. I don't know where I'm at with the other video. The electric fuel pump is electrically pumping. I read on a comment somewhere, somebody said that their 82 6.2 diesel wouldn't start unless he had the block heater plugged in. I thought, well, I'll just go plug the block heater in. Except for now it's 30 degrees. And yes, that is a blanket on top of the engine.
Let's give her a go. Nothing.
At this point, you think you're going to get some outtakes, but you're not going to get any outtakes. And that's because in doing my editing here, over here in your library, you grab a video clip and you drag it into your timeline. And then you do your editing, and that's where the outtakes come from. If I cut this in half and I say, I don't want this. If it's a worthwhile outtake, I'll drag it over here into this folder. And if I click on that folder, all those outtakes should be there. But when the program crashed, it took all those with it. And I am not going to go back through this whole thing and try to find out where all the outtakes are. So you don't get any. Now, I'm also going to cut you off at the pass or head you off at the pass. This was recorded back in the spring. Actually, before that, when I said it's months later, it was months later. That's just the way it is around here. So you get what you get. And yes, I'm still injured. This was before the wreck. Got it?
Looks clean to me!